Well, it's weird because the way that I became a DJ was that DJing kind of found me, at least as a job. Like when I first bought turntables, I just wanted to buy a lot of cool records. There was only, like it was right before MP3s kind of popped off, and there was a lot of stuff that was really cool that you could only get that came out on vinyl or sometimes on like a single or a CD single or something. And I just wanted to have more music and being a young music nerd like people tend to be in their teenage years. I was just trying to have everything. And it's like, oh, I have to get turntables if I want to buy all these cool records. Well, the solution started with me and another DJ named Sound Supreme, who's a great DJ and a great friend, basically deciding like, hey, we're doing too many top 40 gigs that aren't really that much fun, and we want to do the kind of party we would want to go to. And so it's called The Solution because that was literally like our solution to not enjoying our DJ gigs. And DJing for stuff that might maybe look cool on the outside or sound cool or whatever, but maybe it wasn't as much fun as going to, you know, a cool house party or a really cool like private event or a show or whatever. So basically, you know, a club kind of pissed me off and I was like, all right, now's the time. He was like my DJ homie that I was kicking it with the most, and you know, it's like, we need to start our own party. Like, I have some connections that I think we could do it. And we kind of made that happen, and we're talking about names, and we threw out The Solution. It was like, oh, that's perfect, because that's literally like what this is. Like, this is our, you know, attempt to make the kind of party we want to go to. And then with Goodness, you know, a time when there weren't really that many gay parties going on, period, and especially not in Denver. And it was one of those things where, you know, I knew the Metal Light had a really cool patio and I always liked it. And they couldn't do stuff at night when there was music on the patio. It's like, oh man, we could solve all these problems. And then on top of that, like, you know, it's like, man, like I know a lot of cool DJs. It could be more of like a guest-oriented thing where it's, you know, Goodness with DJ Loki and friends versus me with another like set partner or any kind of regular rotation. So because of that, it kind of creates a whole different kind of party where every single time we do the party, it's like a one-on-one. You know, there's people that play the party multiple times, but we never like duplicate any of the lineups. I want to do both all the time, to be honest. And one of the things about it is it's kind of impossible to do both, because to really like cultivate a strong local thing, you have to be in the city that you're trying to cultivate a thing. You know, it's like if you think of a party like a garden. It's like, if you want to have a decent garden, you need to be there to water it. And you might not have to water it every day for it to be a decent garden, but you have to be there the majority of the time paying attention to it if you want to have any kind of substantial crops. And, you know, going out of town is amazing. And I still do some out of town gigs pretty much every year, at least a few things. And it's always such a fun thing because, like, at this point, like, you know, there's this kind of, it's like a network of people that are kind of like fighting a good fight in a very like informal way.